True.
I've lost
Thank the good Lord for that.
My home, my family, my livelihood.
Hasn't she shown up yet? She knows full well my husband and me would take care of her. She'd have a roof over her head and food enough till she could go back to Scarlet's.
I have to go to Rattai tomorrow. They told me Sir Radzik has made camp there. I could ask after her.
Would you? I'd be beholden to you. May God keep her safe.
Don't worry. She'll be all right. I'll bring word to you as soon as I get back.
Much obliged.
I was told to pick up a kit here.
Name?
Henry.
And? In fealty to?
Sir Radzik Kobola.
Yes, I've got you. Well, come on in then. Make yourself at home, Henry. If my memory serves me, you're entitled to a helmet, a gambeson, and a club.
That's all.
You want a kiss and a hug as well?
I mean equipment.
It's quite enough for patrolling the town. You're there to stop trouble, not start it.
I'd love to get something to eat. I'm starting to get up.
came from over here. What is it?
My respects to you.
Here I am. My name is Henry. We're supposed to go on patrol together?
I see you're kitted out.
Ready to get going.
I'm Nightingale. Aren't you that lad the mill wench brought here on a cart?
Teresa. Yes, she rescued me. She turned up with Captain Robot and his knights.
Oh, what a girl. She had a ball. Tell me, how did you pay her back?
Well, I thanked her.
That's not much, is it? You should go and see her when you get a chance. So how did you end up in the service of the bailiff?
I want to enter the service of Radzik, but I'm here to learn.
And learn you will. You're lucky, lad. The Radzik might like you. Most of all, it would have just sent you on your way. Come with me, Henry.
We'll patrol the town and then check on the taverns to make sure they lock up in the evening.
I'm ready.
Don't forget, I'm supposed to try you out and, with the help of God, teach you something. So I expect you to deal with any misconduct yourself. I'll make sure you don't do anything too stupid. Let's go. This is our church. It serves not only as the house of God, but as the crypt of the Lords of Lypha, our masters. The gravedigger lives right round the corner. The priest, too. Our parish priest. A man shouldn't speak ill about servants of the Lord.
help me, people, please. Up close to Hamilton, I lost everything I had.
This is our rat house. Pretty big, eh? The bailiff and his hands live there, and our maestro proto-notarius, the scribe.
Jesus!
And the jailhouse.
Look where you're going!
We don't want to see the inside, not even as a guard. Naturally, we have an executioner too, but he doesn't live in town. That wouldn't be proper, as I'm sure you know. He lives by Gallows Hill, on the side of the creek. This pillory was brand new in autumn, and two people have already been rotting on it. The swordsmith lives here. What the hell is going on here now? Go and check it out, Henry.
Go back to York. I don't want you here. Is that veneer pile not big enough for you?
What are you two screeching about? Stop making such a ruckus.
About time you turned up. This filthy beggar thinks.
My name is Jane.
No one cares what your name is. This filthy beggar thinks she can come and stink in front of my shop. I want you to get rid of her.
What's the problem here?
This is my shop, and I won't have beggars sitting on my doorstep. Let her go and squat in the square. She won't be in anyone's way there, and there's plenty of folk to beg from.
Can't you show us some Christian charity, Armourer?
What? Have you any idea how much I've given away in alms, even to this witch only yesterday?
Is that true?
Might be, might not.
Did you get any alms or not?
Yes.
From the armorer here?
I don't know. And even if I did, that was yesterday, and my belly's empty again today.
That's true.
What would you know about it?
Here, Jane. Take this and be on your way.
Yes. Yes, thank you. I'll go right away. Right away. God bless you, Henry.
And what happens if she comes again tomorrow? You give her more? You're making a mistake. Give them coin once and you'll never see the back of them.
If you say so.
Neighbors are living here now. It's a bit of a shithole. Even so, you should be thankful to Zahanush. If the town burghers got their way, your folk wouldn't be let anywhere near the town. And now our people aren't too happy with him. Some fools are even calling for Zahanush to finally hand the fiefdom over to the young lord, Sir Hans Capon. Sir Hans's father, old Sir Yeshke, may God rest his soul, kept it till he was an old man. Then he retired from it, first to Moravia, then to eternity. Sir Hanush is managing the fiefdom until Sir Hans comes of age. They're related by blood somehow. Same great-great-grandfather or some such. The time's coming soon enough when the estates have to be handed over. These affairs often end in conflict. I hope we have nothing like that here.
Someone there.
This square here, it looks much better during the markets. Then it's filled to bursting with folk from all around. We've also got the baker's shop here, and that mad merchant Wolfram Pruder. Pruder has a pretty daughter, but he keeps her on a short rein, which the young bucks are none too happy about. I heard he even keeps the poor lass locked up at home all day. There's one alehouse here on the market square, the Trader's Tavern. The other's up by the gate. We'll be going there later. Let's move along to the Inner Bailey. Look here. See that filthy beggar? By Christ, I'll show the bastard. Comfortable, are we?
My father was the master blacksmith. He was killed in Scallets.
Ah, I'm sorry. I didn't know.
Thank you. So am I.
My papa died not long ago. Of course, it was old age got him. That's not the same, but I know a little how you feel. Rate fiefdom is pretty big. Naturally, it starts here by the town and continues along the Sassau River all the way to the coast. Master Sahil is in charge of Sir Hanush Stables. He's by far his best vassal. It's all a bit complicated for a newcomer, I suppose. This lord here, that lord there, this exemption here, that right there. Exemption, exemption, rights to half, something, so on. It'd take you a year to make head or tail of it. This tower was only half the size when I was a young lad. Sir Hanush had extended in May days to an armory.
Good day to you. What do you need?
Oh, I see. Now, where might he have got to, then?
I don't know.
You don't know, eh? Let me tell you something. When the bailiff finds out Moimir's slacking off, he'll be in serious shit. And being a friend of his, you wouldn't want that, would you?
No.
So it's better if I deal with it and we leave the bailiff out of it, right?
Yes, I suppose so.
So where is he?
In the tavern. He was thirsty, so he...
went for an ale. We know how that goes. Come on, Henry. Let's go and find that idler, and you'd better talk some sense into him.
What the fuck are you doing here when you're supposed to be on the gate?
Huh?
Move your carcass and go and guard the gate. Not a word. Get moving. You're lucky it was me found out, not the bailiff. Or, God forbid, Captain Bernard. Out! Fool got me all worked up.
Shouldn't we be on patrol instead of drinking?
You're eager, aren't you? Don't worry. Even watchmen are entitled to a break. Except the ones on the gate and the tower, of course. But that's enough about that. Let's not let it spoil our day. Listen, since we're sitting here anyway, how about a little game?
Why not?
No point in pushing it. This'll be the one. Should I? Shouldn't I? No, I daren't.
this'll be the one.
Just one more thing and we're done for the night. Ringing the end of the day and closing the taverns.
Isn't it still a bit early?
I don't know how it was in Scarlet, but here in Rate we close up at this hour. Except, of course, during fairs and big festivals. Then we don't close at all.
I see. Should I go and ring the bell?
If you wouldn't mind. The bell is hanging outside the Rat House. Ring three times, then go to the Trader's Tavern by the Market Square and make sure the innkeeper closes up.
I'll do that.
Before I forget, it's forbidden to walk your rat day at night without a torch. Here, take this one.
Be a bit more careful. What the hell are you doing?
Jesus Christ be praised,
sir.
I
didn't even hit a pothole. I was just rolling along, and it went crack out of the blue.
Bad luck comes in threes, eh?
So, it's back to the wheelwright again, and more to pay.
Good Lord will bring you peace. I pray for that every night.
And the canon of St. Wenceslas in Olomouc was so drunk, he dragged the pig to the market square, saddled it up, and rode it out of the town gate. now we can see that this wasn't going to end well. So Sir Peter and I rode off to look for the good cannon on his peak.
Did you find him?
We tracked the filthy beast down to a sty beyond Cronau. I mean, the beast with a tonsure on its head. We never found the real pig, but the reverend was sound asleep in the pigsty.
Birds of a feather stick together. It seems the same goes for pigs and prelates. A toast, gentlemen, to pigs and prelates.
Y'all seem to have bacon.
Sir Hans, forgive my intrusion, but I need...
Oh, but what? You want to join us? Want to buy us around? I'm afraid we don't drink with peasants. You're not in your village now, boy.
No, sir. Curfew's been rung. The alehouse is closing.
Nothing closes while I'm sitting here. If that's all, you're dismissed.
Are you out of your mind, lad? You can't cross his lordship. He's got a temper like a bear with gut ache. If I was you, I'd get lost before he shows it.
The bailiff instructed me to close the tavern at the proper hour. He doesn't want anyone disturbing the peace after curfew.
The bailiff? The bailiff can kiss my arse. I trust you haven't forgotten who's the rightful lord of Ratte.
No, it's Sir Hannes.
Oh, is he here? What is he? He's hiding under the table, maybe. No, then what he wants isn't worth a fart in a bathhouse. And besides, he's only in charge till I grow up.
Which clearly hasn't happened yet.
Enough. You can't talk to me like that. I'm a nobleman.
Come now, sirs. You're not going to fight here, are you?
We most definitely are. This yokel needs to be taught his place.